Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the questions related to distance and direction. This is very interesting and easy topic to score well. There is a simple theorem behind this type of question. It is called Pythagoras theorem. The Pythagoras theorem says that if you have a triangle like this, it has a right angle. The length of this side is ABC. Then theorem says that a square plus b square is equal to c square. For example, suppose a is 3, b is 4, then 3 square plus 4 square is equal to c square. It means 9 plus 16 is equal to c square, 25 equal to c square. If c square is 25, then c is the root of 25. It is 5. So here c is 5. You have to just understand this theorem, then we will come to this later. Theorem basically says that square of the longest side is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. If you understand this and visualize the question, that's it, half is done. The question will take you into different directions and you have to move along with. In the end, you may be willing to get this type of questions more. That is the beauty of this question. Before going to solve some problems, we first discuss the different directions. Generally, there are four main directions. This is north, south, west and east. If it is going to be difficult for you to remember this, I would rather suggest drawing this just after entering the exam hall and getting a rough paper from the invigilator. And it can be written even before the exam starts. Along with these four directions, there are also some sub-directions like northeast, northwest. You can understand, it is the combination of north and east, it is northeast. Now south and east, it is southeast and southwest. Usually three types of questions are coming related to this topic. One is related to the distance, the second one is related to the direction, and the last one is related to the combination of direction and distance both. Now let's take some real questions from the previous papers and see how it works. This is a question from 2017 November. So let's start. There is a postman. He walked 20 meters straight from his office. So let's suppose this is his office. He starts straight from his office. We can draw this in any direction, but the later part will be dependent upon the first line. So suppose I am drawing here, this is 20 meters straight from his office. Then he turned right and walked 10 meters. So if he is going to right, then I had to draw like this. Otherwise, if it is left, I had to draw like this. Then after turning right, he walked 10 meters. After turning left, again he is turning left and he walked 10 meters. Then turning right, walked 20 meters. So again he is walking 20 meters after turning right. He again turned right, so this way he is going, and walked 70 meters. How far he is from his office? So this is the ending point and this is the starting point. So we have to find the length of this distance. So what we have to do is that we apply Pythagoras theorem here. We will create a right triangle here and we will find the length of this side and this side. So automatically we can get the length of this side. How to get length of this side and this side? For that purpose, we will complete this rectangle. The length of this side will be 10. The length of this side will be 10. The whole length of this side will be 30. So same year it will be 30. The old length of year also it will be 30 because it is 10 plus 20. So year also 30. We got the length of this side, it is 30. How to get length of this side? It is basically old length minus 30. So it will be 40 year. So we got the two length of the right triangle, 30 and 40. So it's very easy to find the third side. So it will be 30 square plus 40 square equal to C square. It will be 900 plus 1600 equal to 2500 is equal to C square. Then C is basically the root of 2500. It will be 50. So 50 is the length of this side. So postman is 50 meters far from his office right now. So the answer is the first option. Now let's see another question. This is the question which is the combination of direction and distance both as well. So one day Prakash left home and walked 10 kilometers towards south. So here it is Prakash. So he is going to south 10 kilometers. Turn right. After coming here, his right is this side. Turn right and walked 5 kilometers. Turn right, again he is turning right this direction and walked 10 kilometers. And turn left. Now he is turning left this direction and walked 10 kilometers. How many kilometers will he have to walk to reach his home straight? So basically he has to cover this distance again. So this it is 10. So the corresponding distance for this will be 5, because when we are completing this rectangle, it is 5 years, so it will be 5 years as well. So 10 plus 5, it is 15. So totally he has to walk 15 kilometers more to reach his home. Third is the our answer. So this is very simple. We have to remember the direction, what is the south, north, east, west, then right and left. That's it. This is the another question from 2015 December. Let's read this question carefully. Anil, after traveling 6 km towards east. So he is starting from here and traveling to east 6 km. After traveling 6 km towards east from his house, he realized that he has traveled in a wrong direction. He turned and traveled 12 km towards west. This was east, so west is opposite of this. So he again traveled 12 km towards west. Turned right, then he is turning this direction, that is his right, and traveled 8 kilometers to reach his office. So he traveled 8 kilometers to reach his office. The straight distance of the office from his house is, basically we have to find this distance. We know already the length of one side, it is 8. Now we have to find the length of this side. The total length of this is 12 and this is 6. Then the length of this side will be 12 minus 6, that is 6. Now we will apply the Pythagoras theorem. So it is a square plus 6 square equal to c square. Basically this is c. 64 plus 36 is equal to c square. 100 is equal to c square. So c is basically 10. So the fourth option is the correct answer. So after analyzing three different questions, you got a flavor how to solve the questions related to the direction. First of all, you simply visualize it, draw the picture, complete the diagram like rectangle and triangles, apply the Pythagoras theorem, that's it.